To thank all the master， 非常感謝各位師傅今日為我哋咁精彩嘅表演。咁啊，阿慶咧，大家見到啦，佢個分享咧，簡直我都唔知點形容，實在精彩無比啊，真係好好。咁啊，容許我俾大家一個機會啦，去問下問題。So I would like to take this opportunity to have two questions, please. Only two questions. Yes, one from India. Yes.
I noticed when Master Wong was demonstrating Hakka Kung Fu, that with the thrust was also a lot of the sounds that he made, like the and it's kind of I could kind of see the similarity with the Hakka, which is a kind of a traditional war cry sort of and slash dance sequence by the Maori people in New Zealand, the Hakka. So are there actually any similarities, or is that just like my assumption that I made?
Thank you for a good question.
Well, I think breathing is a very fundamental aspect of any human movement, particularly warlike activities. So I think there is a certain connection there. There is no ethnic or cultural connection, as far as I'm concerned, between the Hakka of China and the Hakka of the Maori people, the Hakka dance, so to speak. But I think a fundamental similarity resides in the fact that both are extremely warlike people. And whereas the Maori people have lost their martial tradition since the British occupation many years ago, over the past few decades, we've seen a huge revival in the interest and practice of Maori martial arts as a way to reclaim their cultural heritage and to reposit their identity. And I see the same thing applying to the Hakka people. So their martial tradition is integral to their identity, self-identity.
Yes, second question, please. Yeah. I would like to the audience that can also hear your question. Please use the mic.
Yeah, I don't know if they can hear me. Anyways, thank you very much. It was very inspiring indeed. I was wondering about the accessibility of Kung Fu culture in terms of the effort that you have to invest to understand and to really perform or being able to do something. Like, it may take years for someone, and also in terms of gender, because I saw like I see a lot of men involved and not so many women. So how accessible is it for a foreigner? How many years should I have to invest? And how is it for a woman to, you know, participate in this?
I think martial arts should, in essence, become more and more accessible, because a lot of the traditional conceptual barriers we have, such as, for example, Hakka Kung Fu is a very good example in case, because in the past they would say, if you're not Hakka, I'm not going to teach you. If you're not from my lineage, if you're not a Wong, if you're not a Fu, you're not a Ta, forget that, I'm not going to teach you. If you're from a village outside, no, I'm not going to teach you. But all of that has changed. So if you ask Master Wong, Master Fu or Master Tao, they will teach anyone. They really would. Because if you're a true master, if you're passionate about the art form, you don't want it to die with you. And more importantly, I think the way we understand, practice, and teach martial arts has also evolved over time. Now we take a more practical and more scientific approach to teaching, so we also want to make it more effective.
Once again, thanks so much for the really wonderful sharing by Hing and all the Kung Fu Master. 非常感謝各位師傅今晚咁精彩表演啦。咁啊，即係問題咧，大家每個都有噶啦。今日亦都咁 inspire。係冇錯啦。咁啊，更加最重要咧就係嚟緊咧，我哋有我哋城市大學咧，其實咧一路咧都好關注我哋嘅學生。So we really care about our student whole person development. Okay, without a very healthy body.Very difficult for us to study, right? So that's why we have a Wing Chun and also we have a Hakka Kung Fu. And these are two of the events that we present to you. And we highly recommend you all to join. And just to let you know, my personal choice will be I'll be joining this event, okay? So please come and join us and I'll call Kung Fu. Thank you very much. 咁啊，接住咧，咁啊，我哋咧都先介紹咗呢個先，然之後一個頒獎，我哋頒獎先啊，不如頒獎先，我哋去翻張第一張相係啦，我哋 take 呢個機會咧，我哋想邀請我哋嘅宿舍處嘅處長啦，阿 Wilson 啦，同埋我哋嘅另外一位 Hall Master 啦 ，Roger 啦，我哋都想邀請一齊出嚟，係啦，一齊頒個獎俾阿慶嘅，啊，咁我哋咧就非常感謝咧，係啦，我哋 hold 住係啦。真係好精彩，咁亦都趁呢個機會，我哋先頒獎先，一陣間我哋再一齊係啦。小心。係啦，這個獎項咧，其實係我哋嘅香港國際行政學院咧特登捐贈俾我哋嘅嚇。 非常感謝，咁當然咧，咁重要嘅時刻咧，我哋都好想邀請埋咁多位功夫師傅一齊出嚟影張合照嘅，多謝。